Hey guys, Captain Matt, Marathon Sport Fishing. We're just getting back offshore today. And I'm Captain Matt, and we have...
Jerry.
Julia.
Jerry.
And Julia said, you know what, I want to catch some fish today. Little did I know nobody else was going to get a touch of rod. She's like, I want a mahi, I want a tuna. So we head offshore. We have a great day. Stellar experience. You guys have fun? Yeah. So grab your life jackets, hang on, welcome aboard the Falcon for our next adventure. And if you haven't already, smash that subscribe button. And if you like the video, give us a big thumbs up. Thank you.
We hooked up?
Grab that other rod, get it out of the way for it. Okay, spin the rod tip out. Rod tip out, you guys. Rod tip out, all the way out, all the way out. Here, back up, stop. Swing the rod tip towards me. Swing the tip towards me. It's a blue runner.
That's what they're
migrating through. Okay, put the rod in the rod holder right there.
As we're cruising a little farther offshore, we're gonna try to do some deep dropping. We go by basically a board or a log here floating, just a small one. So first we start pitching all baits on it. We do see some mahi burning in on us, but they're not grabbing the bait. So we're gonna change up and troll by it next.
Yeah, there's on though. He missed it. Is he on? Is he on? Nice and easy. Just take your time. Reel him. Come over to 2 steps left. Up against the rail. You're gonna keep reeling him. Keep cranking him.
Keep it up.
What you want to do is pull up. All right, keep cranking. You're good. Put your hand up here. There you go.
Keep it tight. He's jumping.
All right. Swing me the line. Swing me the line. Keep reeling. Reel. You got to keep reeling. Go. Reel. Reel.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he gotcha. Okay, put the rod in the holder. Jerry, back it down. Yeah. Careful you don't spool up the reel like you just did.
Yeah.
All right.
Hooked up again, guys. How you doing?
Real.
Yeah, keep it right in there this time. Is he still on?
Yeah, he's on.
Right.
Okay, keep working him. I got him out there. Lou, he's coming. He's pretty. All right, keep reeling. Is he kicking your butt? You got this. Crank. Turn right, Jerry. Turn right. Slight right. Rod tip out. Keep your rod tip all the way out. That way we won't get caught in the motor. Okay, keep reeling.
Is he a flipper?
Yeah, he's a flipper, but okay. It's real easy with him. Just take your time. Okay, now slide me the line. Okay, stop reeling. Another one in the box. Get him. Whoop. All right. Put the rod in the holder. Okay. You caught him. You got to come catch him. You all right? Your hand getting sore? Ouch. He's beating me up. Your fish is attacking me. I don't think this one's a keeper. He's a smaller one. Let's take a look at him. All right. Take 2 steps to your left. Keep up against. Keep the rod tip out. Yeah, this guy's, he's small. All right. Stop right there. Okay, swing me the line. There we go.
All right, guys, I got tuna airborne over here. We're just on the hump. We're just actually cruising by. We were catching the mahi, and we're going a little deeper to a deep drop spot I got, and we had to go right by the hump, so we thought we'd check it out.
Yeah, you got a real fast, you can go.
All right, guys, as you notice, like this is fish is coming on the starboard side of the boat here. I've got Jerry doing a right corner here into the fish. Very important on the humps too. If you turn into the fish and shorten that distance on the line, makes it easier for the angler and a lot less chance that you're going to get sniped off by a shark. As the fish gets close to the boat, you want to spin the rod tip out at about a 90 degree to keep the fish from piling into the propellers. Once he gets about even with the motors or a little in front, then you spin the rod back to the captain so he can grab the line and flip the fish in the boat.
You can add that to the list.
We're gonna add this. That's an awesome tuna. Okay, watch it. Yeah, let's do this.
Hold on to him.
Can you hold him under the gill plate? Well, here's what I want you to do. He's gonna wiggle. He's gonna do this. Do not drop him out of the boat.
All right.
Is that your first tuna?
Yeah. Right.
Right here. First tuna. Thumbs up, no thumbs up.
Jerry, we need to put down that.
There we go.
Two on. We got a double. Leave it in. Hold on. You're good. No. That's a big tuna. All right, we're going to have to work towards him, Jerry.
All right, put him on the other side. Grab the wheel, Jerry, if you don't mind again. You got it. Go. Jerry, more of a right turn. Okay, we're working in on him, guys. He's coming up right here. This actually might be a gaffer. We'll see when we get up here. It took a ton of line. Go. Turn right, Jerry, turn right. Usually I'm running back and forth doing this. Got Jerry Jr. taking a nap. Okay, slow down. Pick up your rod. Swing tip towards me. Keep reeling. Tip towards me. Stop reeling. Another nice tuna. Okay, rod in the holder. So if you hold them upside down, they won't go crazy. Right down the hatch. Nice job. Tuna number two.
Just gotta let him run it off.
All right, Julia's on fish, I think number five or six at this point. You could see she was like rubbing her arms in that last clip there. She's getting a little arm burn just due to cranking in all the fish. She's a trooper at 12 years old.
Okay, keep going. Should I bring these in?
We got tuna busting in front of the boat. Frigate's right in front of the boat. Yeah, don't bring them in. Okay. Keep cranking. You're going to have to pick it up and turn. Okay, go to the right, Jerry. Go to the right. There you go. Keep reeling. You got it. Here, we're going to do this. Put it right on your hip, okay? There you go. Tip out. Push the tip out. Okay, there you go. All right, stop. Swing it to me. Right up. Swing to me. I got to get the line, okay? Right in the holder. Nice. Oh, she's hogging all the fish today, Jerry. There we go.
We can bring some tuna to the holding
pipe. Grab them right here. Like I got them right there. Just grab them. You gotta fight that tuna. Okay, let's say cheese. You are on camera. All right. How you doing? You sick of reeling in fish yet? We got tuna jumping everywhere. I mean, they're hitting ding, you're hitting the front of the boat. Guys, look at the tuna busting here. Man, just everywhere. Look at this. Holy crap. All right, I spun the inside corner. I'm gonna drag the line right over them. Line's gonna come right down through them.
As we're trolling the hump here, guys, we have a mahi mixed in with a tuna slamming. You can see him jumping back there. Julia's just cranking him in. She's been reeling in the tuna, so the mahi's a little easier to crank in than a tuna after you've had three of them things in the boat.
Is she over or under that one?
That's a nice mahi. Keep reeling. Yep, reel. Okay, stop. There we go. Oh, Dad's gonna have to take you shopping. Oh, look out. They'll beat the crap out of you. They're hard to hold.
Jerry moved the bottom rod over to the other side. Okay, start cranking on him. Yeah, I'm gonna flip your.
You want me to put this fish in the box?
Yeah.
Get him in there.
Yeah, I got it. Yep. Yeah, it's working. That's the clicker. Did I? I got asked if I did the thing on the side. You need to turn the clicker off.
Keep coming. Keep coming. Let's go. You've been okay. It's fish number 7. Let's actually number 8 because we forgot about the blue runner. She's been hogging the rods all day. Yeah. Well, nobody else touch one. Jerry, did you get a fish today? Okay, you're gonna pick the rod tip up and go out, 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 and keep cranking. Tip goes out. Tip goes out. There you go. Okay, slide it towards me. Keep the line tight. Now his lines are going right in front of the boat, Jerry. Okay, put the rod in the holder. Last kitty kitty. All right, want to hold him by the tail? Hang on. Casey goes cray cray. All right, turn him sideways. There we go. I'll take a still photo off of this for you. Say cheese.
We're on the way home. Right after we go through all these frigates.
So we had 3 frigates. The deal was we wanted one more fish, or we as in somebody wanted one more fish. I'm not pointing any fingers at who maybe wanted to catch one more. But we were heading back, and right now we got 3 frigates right in front of the boat. We get a little shot of them. There's one right there. We got 2 here. It's alive and active out on the hump this afternoon.
Let's get to it here. The blackfins are kind of interesting. Any tuna you flay is a little different than a mahi or something. I always make a cut on the back. Start there. I come down to about right here's where his anal vent is. And I just skin the belly straight up to about here. You do not want to cut into the stomach or anything on a tuna. Then the top side, again, I run the knife backwards. These football size guys, which we've got a couple of them, and we've got a couple big ones which are buried in there yet. You've got a really tough cartilage right up on top of them up here where this fin comes out. There's cartilage that runs across the top. It's really tough, and on the big ones it's super tough. So just get him cleaned up a little. Once you cut it up through that cartilage up to the head, it's kind of behind the pec fin here, kind of go down at about a 30 degree angle, and I got the knife kind of like this. It's all the way to the backbone, but it's angled up to where I made that first cut across. And you're just gonna wanna run your knife down the bones, down the back. Just gonna get them rolled over. And after you go over the backbone, their backbone's not as pronounced. I'll show you what I'm doing here. The backbone on these guys is not as pronounced as a mahi. So you come up to the backbone, roll it over, and keep going. It's shorter in height-wise. You got pin bones that run all the way down the middle after you cut through them. I just feel my way down the ribs, basically. Down to my cut line. There's our fillet. He's going back on the ice. Keep him nice and cold while we're finishing it up. We've got a couple of the spine fins here. Clean them off of there. So with the tuna, you can see they're kind of round. So I like to, the big ones, I'll actually cut out the pin line that comes all the way down through the fish. Size, I'm just gonna come down the edge of the pin bones. I'm not gonna cut through the skin on the other side, just enough to crack it. You'll see it'll lay flat that way for you. As with all fish, I take the knife here and I'm gonna make a little slit, pick it up just a little, so I can stick my finger in there to get it started. Now these guys especially, I'm gonna start it with this knife and finish it with the dull kitchen knife, because you can cut through the skin real easy on these tuna. So I got my finger through that little hole there. You get him over to the edge, just gonna take my time. I'm holding the knife flat to slightly up. And you just kind of skim down through. Now you can see on the fillet, there's just a little bit of meat on there. To me, that's perfect because there's some tendon on the outside of the fish. You can see that's all gone. Next, you've got this bloodline in the fish. And it kind of concaves into the meat a little bit. I'm gonna fillet that out next. As you get towards the tail, when you go down to the tail, there's tendons in there too. So you're gonna wanna cut it. You're gonna wanna cut in a little bit towards that tail to get them tendons out of there. I'll do it with the backside up first, then I'll flip it over. As you see, I got 3/4 of it's off. Then I'll flip it over to finish up the back cut. I kind of went inside and you can see there's a little bit of a divot. I scooped it out there, guys. All right, we had a great day fishing offshore the other day. So today what I wanna make, I'm gonna make a tuna poke. This is my recipe. There's a lot of different variations when you start looking around. How do you do this? What can you add, not add? So don't be afraid to experiment on your own when you make one. Kind of in a nutshell, these are all the ingredients that are gonna go into the poke. I'll have the full list and the full breakdown of the recipe that I'm doing for you guys in the description below. But we've got a scallion, an avocado, a mango, a jalapeno, soy sauce, ponzu sauce, sesame oil, rice wine vinegar, toasted sesame seeds, macadamia nuts, pickled ginger, cucumber, which gets utilized 2 times in tonight's meal, a little honey, a little Hellman's mayo, and a little sriracha chili sauce. These two will be mixed together 50-50 to make like a drizzling sauce to go over the top. We'll put the whole thing over a little bit of rice. If you guys do not have a rice cooker, this is a bowl out of my rice cooker, and you like rice, I highly recommend getting one. It's pretty simple. If you're gonna make a cup of rice, on the inside of the rice cooker, you can see here, has 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever it's got going on there. You have 1, 2, 3, 4. You put 1 cup from your rice maker, it gives you a cup, put 1 cup of rice in there, rinse. I always rinse it off first, drain it, and you fill the water to the 1 cup level and you hit start. And within a half an hour, it's done and it's perfect every time. And tonight's mandatory cocktail is gonna be a Hendrix gin and tonic. Now I recommend when you're mixing a gin and tonic, it's got a couple slices of cucumber in there. I'm gonna get everything chopped up. First step, I'm gonna take the tuna, which this tuna, as you can see, I've had wrapped in paper towels. They're dry, I've changed them once. So that tuna is absolutely perfect. I'm gonna dice it into small dices, add a bunch of these ingredients in with it, get it melding together, pop it in the fridge for at least an hour, and then I'll pull it out, and then in the interim, I'm gonna slice up the rest of the stuff, mix the sauce, get that ready. So that's kind of the process. It's pretty simple. I'll bring you back in once I get everything kind of prepared. All right, guys, here comes, I've got the tuna diced up, as you can see. That is absolutely amazing looking fish. Take care of your fish. I bleed them out, they immediately go into the saltwater brine and they sit there a couple days before I fillet them, so. All right, I'm reading my recipe list here. I'm going 1 tablespoon of soy. And you wanna mix up your sauces separately before you put it over the tuna so you get an even mixture on it. Okay, if you're the cap guy working for Nakano Rice, I wanna talk to you because this thing didn't have a scored ring on it. I had to chisel it out of there. Anyway.
I do about a level, more than half a tablespoon of that. I'm gonna do half of it, dump the rest. Half a tablespoon of that. I'm just gonna sprinkle the seeds in there.
Finished up chopping up the scallions, the macadamia nuts, the ginger. So when you're mixing your sauce, guys, like I said, you want to do this separately. You can spill it all over the counter. You can see in there like the oil, you know, the types of sauce or the types of ingredients in there, they layer, they mix, but they don't mix real well. So you want to whip that up quick and then hit that over the tuna. That way you've got it mixed really well. Also, I forgot to put, that's the step I put the honey in with. That's the step I put the honey in. I forgot the label is upside down. When you're doing the scallions, I don't use the white part. With your scallion, if you take it and you put it in a cup like that with some water, put it in a window ledge, that's gonna regrow, you guys. So you can probably get two growths off of it before you gotta pitch it out. So that guy will get reused. So with the sesame seeds, I'm gonna put about a tablespoon in there. And then I'm gonna add the rest of the ingredients. The macadamia nuts will give it a nice little crunch to offset the tuna. You can see how fine I've chopped up everything too. So right now, I'm just gonna mix everything up. This is going in the fridge for at least an hour, so all I've got left to do is slice these up and mix the 50-50 for the drizzling sauce. All right, guys, here we go. Again, the tuna and all the goodies have been in the fridge there. They've been over there for an hour, maybe a little longer. Here's the mix of the sriracha garlic sauce and the Hellmann's mayonnaise. And you can mix that stronger flavor-wise or lighter, however you want to, and just to cut up veggies. So I'm gonna hit her up. Again, this is a real simple meal. It's very fresh. I love doing this one in the summer. And if you like some of the veggies or some of the other ones you don't like, or whatever you want to put on it, you can put anything. You can go peppers, you can, you know, it's wide open on what you can put on this. I find the mangoes great on there. The avocado was just a little bit firm, but it was close. I do like jalapeno for a little extra spice. And the cucumber. The balance between like a cucumber and a jalapeno is kind of a neat little balance, how the flavors work out in those guys. Then we're just gonna take and drizzle on some of the special sauce. Kind of it in a nutshell. And today's mandatory cocktail is still full. An hour later, it looks the same. Very bizarre. Very bizarre. All right, so I'm gonna mix this up a little bit. It's absolutely, if you can smell that, man, it smells amazing. Just the mix of like the sesame and all the stuff on there. I'm just gonna grab a couple pieces here, get them all situated before I really start tearing it up. We'll go with the cucumber slice first, okay? A lot of sauce on there. The mango gets slippery when you put the sauce on it. Absolutely amazing. The combination of the flavors in there is huge. If you guys like mango, I definitely recommend putting the mango in there. That's just like the icing on the cake. The tuna is fantastic. Again, if you take care of your fish, this is absolutely fantastic. It's very fresh, The combination of the ingredients here, absolutely an amazing dish. It's real easy to prepare. There's no cooking, nothing involved. You're just mixing up some stuff for a few minutes. Hey guys, thank you for tuning in to today's show. As you can tell, we all had a blast. Julia was tearing it up out there. If you haven't had a chance yet, please smash that subscribe button. And if you like the video or like the content, guys, shoot me a like as well. Thanks for tuning in again. Captain Matt here, signing off for today.